Hello everyone. In this response video, I just want to answer a question that someone asked that I thought offered a pretty good solution in itself. So right here we see the retractable insert that I made yesterday going in and out, and this is of course being driven by this object that we put this script in. If we delete the driver, we see that we can manually control this, so it's basically able to come out whenever we want without the driver, but we'll put that back for now just so we can control it via an automated fashion. Now another thing to note is that this begins at 57 and near the end it goes up to negative 57, so that means that we want to change the values up a little bit for our transformation constraint in order to be slightly offset, and that should give us a nice pop out effect. First thing I'm going to want to do is parent each of these to their piece underneath, which will cause a slight offset. So we'll pause it right here and let's just fix it. We'll take this one, bring it up. This one and bring it up. So now we're back, and if we play it back we get something like this. Now another thing to note is the first frame and usually the last frame is 250 in normal scene. When we look at the last frame, we want it to begin and end kind of in the same position so that way it loops somewhat nicely. Just don't want to see that stutter. For this first one, we'll go with negative 40 and negative 47. For this next piece, we'll go with negative 27 to negative 20. On the third piece, we'll go with 7 to 17. And on the final piece, we'll go with 30 to 37. And we let this play back. We have a much better lens effect happening here. And here we'll just save the file one more time and see sharpen an object real quick. ANI lens 3. And let's jump over to smart mode where we can use the object picker to reconnect this. And go to minimal. So with that, we have created our retractable camera insert and we have it popping in and out in stages. So with that, I'll see you guys next time.